In this nugget, we get to dive into an IPv4 Ethernet broadcast to create one and verify what it looks like with Wireshark. Let's begin. What kind of destination address could Bob's computer use to send a frame into the network that would be seen and processed by all the other devices that are on that same VLAN? And the answer is an IPv4 Ethernet broadcast frame. The destination layer 2 address is going to be a MAC address of 48 bits in the on position. And that can be represented by 12 hexadecimal characters of all Fs. Examples of IP version 4 protocols that can use a broadcast would be an ARP request. For example, if Bob needs to find the layer 2 address of his default gateway, which is 10.0.0.40, and his PC has been configured to use that IP address for the default gateway, Bob's computer needs to discover what the layer 2 address is associated with that IP address. So an ARP request is going to be broadcast. The switch is going to forward that frame to all those devices so that everybody on that VLAN, the server, Lois's PC, and the router, and each of those devices is going to start de-encapsulating it to take a look at what's inside. They simply can't help themselves. They receive a layer 2 broadcast, and their protocol stack says, oops, it's a broadcast. It may be important. Let's go ahead and start de-encapsulating it. Now, in the case of an ARP request, when all these devices see that it's an ARP request looking for the MAC address associated with 10.0.0.40, only the router is going to reply back because only this router has that IP address, and the router will reply back to Bob's PC saying, hey, this is my MAC address associated with the IP address of 10.0.0.40. The reply is not broadcast, it's unicast, because in the ARP request, Bob sent along his layer 2 address to begin with. So the initial request is broadcast, and the reply that comes back is unicast. So what you and I get to do is we'll set up a very simple scenario with just two routers, router 1 and router 2, connected back-to-back together with Ethernet. We'll issue a ping request, which is going to initiate ARP, to resolve the layer 3 address to a layer 2 MAC address. And then, as we look together at the Wireshark capture, we can verify that the destination layer 2 address indeed is using a broadcast, and we can see what that looks like from the protocol analyzer. For our demo, we're going to build this inside of GNS3 because it's super easy to do a packet capture in GNS3. And if you're new to GNS3 or you want to get up and running fast with GNS3, I would have you check out our GNS3 nuggets as part of the GNS3 course. In fact, the very last video is an update video for GNS3 version 1.x, which can walk you through how to get up and running very, very quickly. I'm going to name this project Broadcast. Click OK. And I'm going to go ahead and add a couple of routers to our topology. I'm going to have a router 1. And I'll drag out a router 2. And I'm going to connect them together with this link tool by clicking on router 1, selecting Ethernet 1/0, and then connecting over to R2 on Ethernet 1/0. I'm going to click this tool again to go ahead and turn it off. I'm also going to click on the label tool, and then I'm going to go ahead and start these two routers by clicking on the green go icon. To open up a console to all the devices, we click on the console icon here, or we could individually click on R1, right click, and from the drop-down, select console. And my current computer is set up with Secure CRT, but there's also options for PuTTY as well for a terminal emulator. And I also want to bring up R2, so I'm going to right-click on R2, click on console, and I'll have consoles for each one. There's R1, there's R2. And all we really need to do is put a basic IP address on R1 and R2, and then we can capture the traffic as it happens between those two routers. So here on R1, let's go into interface E1/0 and bring it up with a no shutdown command. And then let's give it the IP address of 10.0.0.1 with a 24-bit mask. So now our E1/0 interface on R1 has an IP address. The interface is up. Let's go ahead and do the same treatment for R2, except on R2 we'll use the IP address of 10.0.0.2. So here on R2 we'll go into configuration mode, and then we'll go into interface E1/0 and bring it up with the no shutdown command, and then give it the IP address of 10.0.0.2 with a 24-bit mask. So if we were to do a ping, for example, or any type of communication between 10.0.0.1 and 10.0.0.2, R1 would have to invoke ARP to learn initially what the layer 2 address is associated with R2's address of 10.0.0.2, and that ARP would use a broadcast, and that, my friends, is what we want to capture. So to capture this traffic, we're going to right-click on this link between R1 and R2, I'm going to click on Start Capture, and it gives me a choice. Do I want to capture the traffic on E1/0 of R1 or on E1/0 of R2? And it really doesn't matter because it's going to be the same traffic going between those two devices. So I'm going to select R1 port 1/0 and click on OK. And by default, it's going to bring up Wireshark. We'll set that off to the side just for a moment. Let's go back to Secure CRT, And then secure CRT, let's go over to R1 and let's do a really easy ping over to 10.0.0.2. You'll notice the first packet didn't make it. We didn't get a response back, and the remaining four pings did. That's because the first one was consumed while we were doing the ARP request, trying to resolve the layer 3 address of 10.0.0.2 to a layer 2 address. If we use the command show ARP, that will verify that we indeed do know what the layer 2 address is. That maps over to the 10.0.0.2 layer 3 address. So now if we bring out our packet capture, I'll bring it over here. I'm going to go ahead and click on stop. And I'm also going to save this and have it part of the Nugget Lab files for your reference. So we'll do a file, save as, and we'll save it as the name IPv4 Ethernet Broadcast, and we'll click on save. So we have a whole bunch of traffic here in this output. So let me rearrange the interface just a little bit. And we can choose the panes that we want to see here. If we want to modify that, we can go to view, and then we can see the packet list, that's the top section, the packet details, which is the middle, and then the packet bytes, which is the bottom section. So if we wanted to search for ARP, there's a couple of ways of doing it. We could actually use a display filter, type in ARP, press enter, and that would show us only the ARP-related packets. Or we could click on clear to remove that display filter and simply look for the ARP request. And it's right here in packet number 11. The request is saying, who has the IP address 10.0.0.2? Please tell me, I'm at 10.0.0.1. If we select that entry, and we go down here and look at the details for the layer 2 header, the destination address is the broadcast address. The all ones in binary, or in hexadecimal, that would be 12 Fs. It's also showing us the hex representation at the very bottom. However, one thing we could do is we could right-click on this bottom section and say, I want to see it in the bits view instead of the hex view. Click on bits view, and here it's showing us the 48 literal bits that are on in that broadcast layer 2 destination address. And to verify that, we could click on the destination address here, and it would highlight the corresponding binary below. And if you'd like more training specifically just on Wireshark, there's an entire Wireshark course right here at CBT Nuggets as well. In this nugget, we took a look at what an Ethernet IPv4 broadcast would look like. We created a scenario which would invoke ARP so we could create the broadcast on the network as part of the ARP request. And we used Wireshark to verify the details of what was actually happening on the wire. My recommendation based on this video would be for you to lab this up on your own to produce those same results. I have had a great time in this nugget. I'm so glad you joined me for it. I hope this has been informative for you, and I'd like to thank you for viewing.